Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so after about 7 hours of watching The Boys, the season, absolutely love it. I'm finally recording a video at 3 a.m. Absolutely love it. Hit like for every time I've recorded a video at 3 a.m. because YouTube. Either way, we'd be going over a video of should you summon for the new Light Elizabeth character that will be dropping on Global in about 24 hours, like exactly as I'm recording this video. We'll be going over the banner, her skills and whatnot, and yada yada yada. And yeah, let me know down below, who do you guys need on the banner? I need a few units on Global, but yeah. If you go through the banner, it's kind of a letdown. I can't lie. All the units besides Bloody Elizabeth will be level 86 star, so that's pretty nice. But when you keep scrolling down to the banner, you start to see some questionable units that you're just like, how did they get on this banner? There is 26 SSR units on this banner. 6 of them are Fest units, which the Fest units are probably like perfect. Sorry about that. Except for like, I could see maybe taking off Purgatory Bond because he's realistically only used in PvP. At least Eskenra is using Deer. Margaret is a really good unit with the new Elizabeth. King blitzes through Tower of Trial, one of the best farming units, and he's still pretty decent in PvP. He's godly if you go first usually, and Trader Melee is used on like basically everything. And then obviously Elizabeth is a new unit. But Bond really, really falls off. He's like mainly a PvP unit, and then I guess he works on Final Boss as well. But I wish that they would have slapped Diane in here. I know why they didn't. It's because she was the most previous Fest unit, so she's not in here. Just a lot like with Tarmil, he was the most previous like basic banner unit, so that's why he's not on here. They'll most likely be on a part 2 Fest or just like the next Fest unit. So yeah, there's that. But yeah, overall it's a pretty mid banner for most players, but overall I think for like newer players it's pretty good. Except the rates. The rates are horrible. 4% and she's only a 0.25%. Like, she should have at least been 0.5. But they cucked every single rate in the game. Like, they're all 0.15. Why are they so low? It's horrible. But we'll scrape past that because I hate this banner. I hate this banner. That's all I'll go over that. But what are we going over the actual unit now? Bloody Elizabeth is the first light attribute unit. She's a goddess. And, she has a 7-paragraph passive, so let's get into it. When a specific ally uses a basic skill, increases basic stats of that ally by 4%, up to a maximum of 6 times. So basically what this means is if you use a Sin or an Archangel every single time you use one of their cards, like a Taunt, a Cleanse, anything like that, you will get one of her passives procced, so up to 6 times. Once you hit that 6th passive, if increased to max, recovers HP a specific ally by 30% of max HP, then increases all the hero stats by 15% for 5 turns. And this is where Bloody Elizabeth starts to get actually meta. Without this passive, she's extremely mediocre, so you have to run her with a full Archangel or like a mix of set of the Sins or Archangel, one of the two, or I guess full Sin, I guess. I'm very tired, I'm sorry. So she is limited to an extent, so basically no demons besides Meliodas. I guess some of the giants. Only King is the fairy, but then I guess then again there's like 2 fairies. I guess there's 3, but still. She is limited but not extremely, like a lot, like Assault Melee or Gringoether, I guess, is it 2.
Oh my goodness. This is horrible.
Actually horrible, dude. I have to go to bed. Basically not that limited. I don't know why people are complaining about it. Like, yeah, you can't rock her with Assault Melee realistically. Like, maybe you could, but I don't see it really working out too well. There have been some extremely good teams that I have seen. So comment down below, do you guys want to see what gear she wants or what best teams are first or for her first? And yeah, let me know down below. So basically her first card is a flood damage card, and people always mix this up. A flood damage is based off the percentage of their HP. So if they have HP defense gear on, they would still be at 100%. You would still only get the 0.8%. So you'd be doing an extra 80% damage. If you had 80 HP because you have attack defense gear, you would still get the extra 80% additional damage because it's attack defense. It's based on your percentage, not your max HP like the Purgatory Bond or Fez Gother in terms of his ult. So there's that. But pretty standard, just a bonk card. It hits multiple times, so it's super good because when it doesn't crit, it's not too crazy. But when it starts to crit, which if you have her passive and whatnot and a bunch of stuff going, she usually always crits. So it can hit really, really hard. And then this card, Volley of Light. I think this is the card that makes her really good. I don't like her flood as much compared to this card. Granted, it could be because I ran her with HP crit damage on your PvP. I'm not making an attack crit damage Liz set, sue me. But basically, Volley of Light inflicts damage equal to 110% of attack on all enemies, and for each ultimate move gauge orb, inflicts additional damage equal to 3% of max HP. So this is the one that will scale off max HP. I personally don't like these cards because it makes a unit hit extremely, extremely hard with HP defense gear. Or HP crit, I guess, for some people. And when that happens, you get another Purgatory Bond situation. And I genuinely hate it because it's just a tankier unit that'll have more stats and just never dies, really, unless you one-shot them. And it's super annoying. But at least she doesn't full heal every single card turn with her heal card, I guess. So that's somewhat more fair, I guess. So yeah, and then it goes all the way up to 275% and a max of 8% of max HP. So really, really good. This is the card that I genuinely prefer in my opinion, but depends. I don't know. And now we're going to be going under her ultimate, Jonah's Suffering. What is this name? Oh my god. Is that from the... Okay, I'm not going to say anymore. Either way, her ultimate inflicts damage equal to 30% of the hero's max HP. So yet again, another card reliant on max HP. On all enemies, applies revive on allies for one turn. And what this revive does is when an ally dies, they're revived with 5% of max HP. Effect is removed upon reviving. Dying by reflect effect nullifies revive and uses it up. So when you ult, it doesn't heal them back from the grave. I thought that's what it was at first release, and I was like, this is broken. But no, you have to ultimate, and then if they die, they would revive with the 5% HP at 1 out of 6. At 6 out of 6, it easily hits 1 to 2 million damage, depending on how much HP you have. You know, like if you have like a Tarmio buff and whatnot, or a Margaret buff or anything like that, because those dramatically increase your HP. But the multiplier goes all the way up to 6% of your max HP, which makes it hit extremely hard. And then the revive multiplier goes all the way from 5 to freaking 50. So if you want to use this Liz's ult effectively, you need a 4-6. You just need a 4-6 or higher. Otherwise, it's pretty garbage. Because if they revive at 5%, you just use like one Lilia AoE or one Pierce card and they're just gone. Like, it just won't even matter at that point. Now this is one thing you need to know. This is why I say 4-6 as well. If you have 1 to 3-6 ultimate and she revives, it's a blue buff. So Rimuru or Blue Lilia's ult will just Rimuru in general will steal the buff. He'll get his max passive and he'll start one-shotting your units. Lilia also removes buffs. A lot of units in the meta removes buffs like Trader Melee, etc. But once you get it to 4-6 or higher, you get the gray buff where you cannot remove it. Which I feel like they're going to drop a gray buff removal unit one day and it's going to be absolutely broken. Maybe next year, Andy, to be honest. Okay, I need to wrap this video up. Oh my god, I'm tired. But yeah, gray buff at 4-6 to 6 out of 6, and that is where the Liz absolutely shines. She nukes the team, she fully revives your units all the way up to 50%, so that way they live for basically an extra 2 turns, and you can't steal the buff. If you want to use this unit effectively, you need a 4-6er. Like, it's kind of a no-brainer, unfortunately. The blue buff is just horrible because it's so easy to counter realistically. Like, if you know that the Liz is absolutely like meta, then just bring a buff removal unit. it's not that difficult. But in my opinion, if I should say if you should summon or not, I think it's a very worth summoning. Now, obviously, you could just wait to see what we get on the next banner with the new leaked Brunhild, potentially maybe your summer Brunhild. We still do have that new skin coming in from Roseanne on Twitter, I guess I'll say. She made the Brunhild outfit, she won, and so maybe that's when we'll get that outfit. Who knows? That'd be really cool. Or maybe it'll just be a whole new thing that we haven't seen leaked yet, because last year was AOT, I believe, the one or two banners after Goddess Liz. Not last year, but after Goddess Liz, year one of JP, so who knows, who knows. But yeah, I think overall with Ragnarok Bond on here, you know, you got the Brunhild's still really good deer unit, really good bird unit. You got Magelda, Jormungandr, Sariel, all these good fests. I think it is still worth it. As soon as you get 1-6 Liz, though, I would say pull out, unless you're like, you know, like past the 600, you might as well finish it. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know down below, are you guys going to be summoning? I would love to summon, but I think I'm just going to summon in the morning, if anything, because 3:30 a.m., that is abysmal. That's literally the time I am right now, and I'm absolutely exhausted. So yeah, take care, peace out, and hope you guys have an absolutely amazing day. Peace.